Hi there, this is Ranjit, and in this video, I'm going to talk about Qualcomm Quick Charging and some of the misconceptions that people have about Quick Charging. And I did a video about Qualcomm Quick Charging just last year. You can actually watch that video to get an idea about Quick Charging. But in this video, I'm going to answer some of the misconceptions that people have about Quick Charging. And Quick Charging is a really convenient feature. It's basically that it charges your phone way faster than a conventional charger. And these days, many of the phones do support Quick Charging. And the fact is that Qualcomm Quick Charging is not the only standard. There are also other standards that other vendors use for Quick Charging. And the basic thing about Quick Charging is that for a typical smartphone battery or a gadget, you can actually charge it really quickly from 0 to 80%. But the last 20% is sort of trickle charge. So what they basically do is, for the first 80%, they charge it really quickly using higher voltages and pushing a lot more current. That's the basic thing about Quick Charging. And for Qualcomm, they have the Quick Charging 1 support, which is actually pretty old. They have the Quick Charge 2, which became actually really popular in 2015. But just recently, they have also announced the Quick Charge 3 support, which is fairly new and not a lot of devices support. So let me talk about the Quick Charging, and to give you a basic idea, I would say, let's talk first about a normal charger that you might have. And if you look at the charger closely, you'll see some readings. And for a normal charger, the voltage would be 5 volts and some ampere rating. For example, 1 ampere. For some of the powerful phones, it will be about 2 ampere. So basically, that's the amount of current this charger can put in your phone. For example, let's say if it's 5 volts at 1 amps, so it can output a maximum of about 5 watts of power to your phone. So your phone can charge at about 5 watts. Let's say if it's 2 amps, that is 5 volts into 2, that's about 10 watts of power. Generally, most of the phones have these days 5 volts at 2 amps. But with a Quick Charger, if you look closely, it will also have other voltages like 9 volts and 12 volts. For example, as you can see from the charge, this chart, 9 volts, they generally, for example, Samsung uses for the Quick Charging 9 volts at 1.67 amps. So that outputs about 15 watts of power for their Quick Chargers. But again, some vendors even go higher. For example, Motorola generally uses 12 volts, and I have seen Motorola's that turbocharger that's really fat. It can actually provide wattage up to 25 watts. That's significantly higher. So again, you have to just look at the charger to see if it supports Quick Charging. If it supports Quick Charging, it'll have output, it'll have the regular output at 5 volts, but it'll also have output at 9 volts and even at 12 volts. Another big misconception that people have is that, let's say if your chipset supports Qualcomm Quick Charging, you will have Qualcomm Quick Charging on that device. For example, I got this question a lot because of this Redmi Note 3, which is having that new Snapdragon 650 SoC. And if you look at the Qualcomm's tech pages, for example, let me just open that. As you can see, this is for the 410, and this is the official page of Qualcomm Snapdragon 650. And if you go down and look at the specs of the processor in the charging, you'll notice that it has Quick Charging 2 support as well as Quick Charging 3 support. Yes, technically this Snapdragon 650 has both the Quick Charging 2 and 3 support, but the thing is that your device might not support the Quick Charging 2 and 3 support. That's the case with this Xiaomi Redmi Note 3, the Snapdragon 650 variant. The thing is that Qualcomm actually charges extra fees to OEMs, that is the phone manufacturers, to implement Quick Charging. And for example, this was a classic case. This was with LG G4 that was launched last year. It had the Snapdragon 808 chipset, which is widely known to have Quick Charging 2 support. But when the LG G4 was launched, it simply did not have the quick charging 2 support, and many users were really angry because the LG G4 is supposed to be a premium handset and it does cost a lot, and then also LG omitted the quick charging, but they could actually enable the quick charging with just a software update. I think so they just paid the extra royalty fees to Qualcomm, and that way they could enable it. So actually these OEMs have to pay an extra fee to Qualcomm to enable the quick charging 2 and 3 support. I don't recall the exact amount, but it was rumored Qualcomm used to charge $5 extra per chip for quick charge 2 support. So that is the main reason that you don't find quick charging 2 or even the new quick charging 3 in budget oriented devices. But again, with flagships you will find those features because these OEMs are okay to pay that extra licensing fee for quick charging to Qualcomm. A classic example again would be this Snapdragon 410 chipset. This is a mid-range processor that was found in a lot of phones, a lot of popular phones like the Moto G3, a ton of other Samsung phones, and very popular phones use the Snapdragon 410 chipset. And if you go down all the way and look at the charging, you'll see that this one also supports the Qualcomm Quick Charge 2 support. But again, none of the phones that I have tested with Snapdragon 410 chipset, and trust me guys, I've tested a lot of phones with Snapdragon 410 chipset, had the Quick Charging 2 support. The simple fact is that OEMs decided not to pay the extra licensing fee to Qualcomm. So again, the fact is that if even if your chipset supports quick charging standards like Quick Charging 2 or 3, don't just assume that it will be there on the device. Check with the manufacturer's website if they have enabled those features. And certainly on this Redmi Note 3, a Snapdragon 650 variant, we don't have the Quick Charging 2 or 3 support. I tested it with Qualcomm certified quick chargers. It doesn't make any difference. These days I've noticed that Qualcomm is just bundling the Quick Charge 1 because as I've mentioned earlier also, this quick charging technology is not just proprietary to Qualcomm. There are other vendors also that implement quick charging. For a classic example is MediaTek also has their own version of quick charging, and this is the LE1S, and this does support quick charging. It just does not use this Qualcomm version of quick charging, but it certainly has support for quick charging. And even Asus, that actually uses Intel processors, have their own version of quick charging. So again, the thing is that for Qualcomm chipsets, OEMs need to pay an extra licensing fee to enable the quick charging, and hence only in the high-end phones we generally find the quick charging 2 and 3 support. But lately I think so Qualcomm is enabling the quick charging 1 support for almost all the devices now. Let me also talk about one more thing, and regarding I get this question a lot. What will happen if I have a let's say Qualcomm quick charger, that is Qualcomm Quick Charger 2, let's say, and I have a phone that does not support quick charging? Will it charge faster? No, this answer is no, it will not charge faster, but you can safely charge it. It won't blow up your phone. But simply to take advantage of quick charging, both your phone and the charger needs to support quick charging standard, appropriate to quick charging standard. And yes, this Qualcomm Quick Charging 3 is the latest version. Only in new phones will start getting this. For example, the Xiaomi Mi 5 will have the Quick Charging 3 support, the LG G5 will have the Quick Charging 3 support. And what Qualcomm has done now with Quick Charging 3, even though the Quick Charging 2 was really fast, they claim that the Quick Charging 3 will be more efficient. The phone will actually communicate a lot with the charger, and the phone will accept only the charge that is required. That way, if you have actually used any quick chargers, particularly Qualcomm Quick Charger 2s, when you charge your phone, you'll notice that the phones get actually really warm. That should technically not happen with Qualcomm Quick Charging 3. And also the Qualcomm Quick Charging 3 will support the new USB-C type ports. So again, I hope you have a lot more info regarding quick charging, and I hope that you found this video helpful. If you found it helpful, I'll appreciate if you can click the like button, and if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button. Thank you. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video.